Part two, perspective. We're going to hit some shading now. So get yourself set. We got two rectangles there over the horizon line and underneath the horizon line. We need a vanishing point here, which will actually become your light source. So that that extra line is the vanishing point light source. So you want to connect things to go in one direction. You can always add different shading later. This is just basic shading, just blocking it in just to get started. So hit the vanishing point underneath for the shadow. And all of these first vanishing points hit under the bottom corners there. So now you're set from the bottom corners to the underneath ground here that matches the vanishing point, and then start to darken them in a little bit. Now get the eraser. Anytime you can get the eraser through, and the eraser can actually work really good in shading too as a tool to help you out. So anyway, get these lines away. It's not that necessary, but just clean it up a little bit. You can always use another level of tracing paper over the top, or if you were drawing directly on the computer, you can use another level. But okay, let's see if we can get the shading going. Underneath, it's darker. This side would be darker because the light source is not hitting it. So you can get the shots going down here, the strokes hitting over the side. You can get as messy as you want, and then later you can start to clean it up a little bit. So try to get a darker line underneath because there's no light on that part. So darken it up here. There we go. All right, and then just move it out as messy as you want, because you can always go around later and smooth it all out. And you can, okay, so let's darken it up underneath. There is no light there, and then just smudge it. Try to get a little bit of your own kind of airbrush look with your finger or smudge stick, and as messy as you like, and then just round it off with the shading again using finger or smudge stick. Here we go, just darken it up here and soften it up. Okay, get the shadow underneath. Now on the other side, let's just block this in like we did on the bottom, because we wouldn't see the light on this side. Go darker underneath, because once again, there's no light there. So you get these contrasts of shading that's happening. But it's all following the one light source that's coming through. So let's just get some more shading on this side here, the right side. And go back to the left here. Just make sure the lines all match up, and then you should be good to go. All right. Darken things up a bit, get your eraser in there, help you out, get some smudging going on underneath, clean up some of the lines. There we go, get it all cleaned up there underneath so we can see the rectangles more easy. All right, now start to just get the lines solid again after that erasing.